Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, once again, let us praise and worship the Lord. If possible, please stand up on your own places and praise and worship the Lord so that the Spirit may come down on each and every one of us to receive the Word of God. Would you please stand up and let's clap the hand and press praise and worship the Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, Jesus. Everybody.
Thank you, Jesus. We praise you, Jesus. We glorify you, Jesus.
I want to scream it out from every mountaintop. Your goodness knows no bounds. Your goodness never stops. Your mercy follows me. Your kindness fills my life. Your love amazes me. And I will sing because you are good, and I will dance because you are good, and I will shout because you are good. You are good to me. I will sing because you are good, and I will dance because you are good, and I will shout because you are good. You are good to me.
Going to both sides. Let us look at each other, one who is near to you, and praise and thank the Lord. Oh Lord, we thank the gift of the person who is next to me. I thank for the family members. I thank for everyone who is near and dear to one to me. Let us praise and worship and thank the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Nothing and no one comes anywhere close to you. The earth and ocean only reflect this.
Almighty God,
you are good to me. I will sing because you are good, and I will dance because you are good, and I will shout because you are good. You are good to me.
Let's praise and worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Powerful God from God. We praise and thank and glorify
you. Thank you, Jesus. We praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Let the power of Jesus come down.
We adore you, Jesus.
Let the power of Jesus move us.
Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Let us keep every intention that is in your heart to the Lord. As the word of God is being said, let us be realized, let us be renewed in the Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters, today I'm going to talk to you something about the Holy Eucharist. I'm sure you have heard a lot of sermons and homilies on Holy Eucharist. Now let's see, what does God speaks or Jesus speaks about Holy Eucharist? Dear brothers and sisters, we everyone know that the special passage concerning the Holy Eucharist is the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6. The chapter 6 begins with two miracles. First miracle is nothing but the multiplication of the bread. And through the multiplication of the bread, Jesus is telling or proving that he can do anything. Second miracle is Jesus walking over the sea. And through walking over the sea, we know a normal person cannot do that. He is proving that he is a divine person, a supernatural person who can even control his body or who can shape his body in whatever way he wants. And after teaching these two important lessons Jesus is speaking about the Holy Eucharist, the bread that came from heaven. And you know, dear brothers and sisters, when we look into the gospel passages, we see what he spoke was not understood by even those people who were near to him. In the Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, when Jesus said, "I am the bread came down from heaven," people were so much murmuring against him. They were murmuring, "Why this man is talking such a thing?" Let us listen to that. The Gospel of St. John, chapter 6, verse 41.
The Jews murmured about him because he said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven."
Praise the Lord. When he said, "I am the bread came from heaven and my body is the real bread," they were murmuring against him. How this man can do that? Next sentence says, "Is not this man belongs to the Nazareth?" Would you read that second sentence more?
And they said, "Is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph? Do we not know his father and mother? Then how can he say, 'I have come down from heaven'?"
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When Jesus is talking to them, everyone knows about Jesus. And they are asking, "See, this man is from Nazareth. We know his parents. And how can this man say that I am the bread came from heaven?" And dear brothers and sisters, when he was again and again asserting that "I am the real bread and all those who eat my body will never die," when he spoke all those things, they were in utter confusion. And you know what happened? In the verse 60, the word of God says in this way,
"Then many of his disciples who were listening said, 'This saying is hard. Who can accept it?'"
See, there was a total confusion. They are saying, "How is it possible? This saying is very hard, and who can accept that?" And you know what happened? After saying this, many of them left him. That is what we see in the verse 66.
"Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him."
See, the disciples who were with him, they said, "This is very hard to believe. A person is going to give his own body as a food to eat. No, we cannot believe that. It is very hard." Many of them went away from his company. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And you know what happened? The next passage is very important. When these people went away, normally, if he wanted to have so many disciples, he could have called them, "Hey, come here. Don't go. As I simply said, you be with me." But Jesus is asserting, he's asking the disciples, "Do you want to go? Do you want to go? If you want to go, you go. But I am not going to change my words." Hallelujah.
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 Dear brothers and sisters, in the verse 67, Jesus asked the 12, read,
"Do you also want to leave?"
See, he's asking, "Do you want to leave?" So dear brothers and sisters, whether you believe it or not, Jesus is telling, this is something new and this is the only teaching God gives. My body is to be given for you. It is to be broken for you. And I am giving my body in the Holy Eucharist, and that is going to be the reason for your eternal life. Hallelujah.
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 Now, dear brothers and sisters, this is the teaching of Jesus. And you know, what does Satan says? Satan always tried to say that Holy Eucharist is no more his body. And what is the reason behind that? Because he knows this is a real presence of Jesus and there is a real body of Jesus. So therefore, Satan is always trying to convince you that there is no Jesus in the body, bread. That is just mere a symbolic action. No, it is not symbolic. It is not symbolic. As a Catholic, you should believe this is not a symbolic action, but Jesus truly and substantially present in the Holy Eucharist. And that is the teaching of the church. You know, the church doesn't accept any miracle as a miracle unless and until it is supported by the science. And that great testing have been made, experiments have been done, and they have proved that this is a real body. You can just go to the Google and type it. I'll just tell you one. There is one incident, bread and wine were turned into body and blood of Jesus. And after 200 years, four different scientists, they were given it for experiment to see what you have to say about this body or this the piece of flesh and blood. And you know, they had almost all of them had a similar conclusion about certain matters. One thing was, this is the piece of a body of a human being who died with so much agony and pain. And there is a part of a tissue taken somewhere from the near heart of a human person. They concluded in that. Secondly, they said the blood group that was in the this blood group was of AB positive, which is said to be the same blood group on which they had covered Jesus. And thirdly, they said after 200 years, this body and blood is same. It has no change. It was kept without any chemicals in a normal place, and it was still without any damage. It was kept intact, and thus it was proved that it is a Eucharistic miracle. So dear brothers and sisters, even the science proves that this is a miracle happening, and sometimes we fail to understand. Hallelujah.
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 Dear brothers and sisters, we should understand the power and strength of the Eucharist that is given to us by Jesus. That is, He Himself is present. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Therefore, dear brothers and sisters, you should give importance to that. That is why in the 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 27 and 28, St. Paul is very categorically saying, therefore, if anyone unworthily received the Holy Eucharist, they are going to be doomed to punishment. We read that 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 27 and 28.
Therefore, whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord unworthily will have to answer for the body and blood of the Lord. A person should examine himself and so eat the bread and drink the cup.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So therefore, St. Paul is saying, you have to examine yourself whether you are worthy to receive it. If unworthily anyone receives it, it is going to be a cause for punishment. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Hey, brothers and sisters, why the Holy Eucharistic celebration doesn't become an experience for you and me? Another reason is that we don't offer this sacrifice with any cost in our hearts. We have to pay price for that. In the 2 Samuel chapter 14, chapter 24, verse 24, the word of God says in this way.
But the king said to Arunah, no, but I will buy them from you for a price. I will not offer burnt offerings to the Lord, my God, that cost me nothing.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
When David wanted to make an offering to God, and when he said to one of his people that he needs to offer a sacrifice, the person, he said, I will give you everything, you just do the offering. Then he said, no, I will not give an offering to God which cost me nothing. So what he did, he gave price and bought all things for the offerings, and he offered it. This also should touch our heart. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And I truly believe Jesus, when he offered the first holy sacrifice on Mount Calvary, it was acceptable to God only because he said, he prayed for the enemies. Oh Lord, they do not know what they are doing. And because of his prayer, his offering was acceptable to God, the Heavenly Father. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's stand up. Let's stand up, dear brothers and sisters. Let us give ourselves totally to God, saying that, Lord, increase our faith. Lord, help us to understand the real meaning of the Holy Eucharist. Today, very often, we do neglect with silly reasons. We don't go to church. We don't go for Mass. We don't participate in the Holy Eucharist. And how many times we have participated in an unworthy manner? Lord, have mercy on us. Give us a deeper knowledge of the Holy Eucharist. Oh, dear brothers and sisters, it is truly a mystery which cannot be fully understood by the human intelligence. Only the faith can teach you all these things. Let us ask the Lord to give you more faith. Let us ask the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Oh Lord, give us grace to understand the power of the Holy Eucharist. Oh Lord, give us the grace to know the meaning of the Holy Eucharist. Oh Lord, it is our consolation in this world. It is the reward, is life eternal with you. And we believe that. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus, we praise and thank you. Hallelujah.
Bread of life, we worship you. Holy One, we worship you. Lamb of God, we worship you. Bread of life, we worship you.
Open our inner eyes so that we may be able to grasp and understand the powerful presence of yours in the Holy Eucharist. Oh Jesus, we believe and we know that you have given your own body as a true food and your wine, your blood as a true wine. Oh Lord, we truly believe that you have given your body and your blood as our food and drink. Today, we ask you sorry for all those moments in which we have not given respect to the Holy Eucharist. Oh Lord, we have attended so many times. We have participated in the Holy Eucharist many times without much interest. Oh Lord, today we pray, have mercy on each and every one of us. Let us be able to have the greater knowledge and faith in your presence in the Holy Eucharist. Oh Jesus, you loved this world so much that you dropped even the last drop of blood for each and every one of us, for our sins. And today, as we venerate, as we adore, and as we pay homage to you, Lord, give us your grace. Let us raise the hands up to heaven. Dear brothers and sisters, believe that Jesus is truly present in the Holy Eucharist. And through the Holy Eucharist, he can do marvelous deeds in your life. Dear brother and sister, wherever you are, raise your hands up to heaven. Jesus is coming and touching each and every one of you. He is ready to come to your heart. He is ready to be in your home. You welcome him. The word of God says, I knock at the door. Yes, he is knocking at the door of every human being. And if you open the door, he will come inside. Let us raise the hands up and praise and thank the Lord and receive the benediction. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Jesus, we praise and glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus, Jesus, come into my home, Jesus. Come into my home. Be yeah.